Hello and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome to my channel. So for those of you who are new, my name is Christiane, otherwise known here as I Heart Airbrush, and today we're going to be diving into the final installment of the Dynair 1 series that I have going here. So if you are interested in knowing my final thoughts on the Dynair 1, as well as some extra specs, do I recommend it and all that good stuff, then please keep on watching. Right, the Dynair 1. Yes, it's been a long time coming. I've sat on this machine for months on end, it feels like. But today I'm finally ready to go ahead and share with you my final thoughts as well as some extra specs that I've found in my use and testing of this device. So if you haven't watched my original Dynair 1 video, I will go ahead and put a card up here or up here for you. I never know which side it is. But there's going to be a card up there for you to go ahead and check that video out and then make your way back here to go ahead and see the final thoughts, final review. So that being said, let's just dive right in, okay? So first things first, what are the attributes to the Dynair 1? These are things, of course, that are in my own opinion with my own experience, okay? My opinion is not Bible. It's just what I feel about the machine with my knowledge and expertise in airbrush makeup. I've only been airbrushing since 2012, so my knowledge tends to start in 2012 and just kind of increase as time went by. So the attributes that I feel the Dynair 1 has is one, that it's compact, lightweight. It has the one speed, which is really nice. It takes any hassle out of choosing a speed that's going to work for you or anything like that. They've already preset that speed for you. It's battery operated. It has a quick connect attachment right here. So if you pull down the little sleeve, pop it up, the airbrush comes off. You can attach as many airbrushes as you want. You don't have to just use Dynair airbrushes like I talked about in my original video. You can also use other brands' airbrushes. Like here, I have the Ket airbrush, and I also have the Temp2 airbrush that I have attached to this compressor, and they work all just fine as long as they have the quick connect male attachment that you see there on the bottom, just like that. As long as it looks like that, you'll be able to use it on the Dynair 1. So let's get back to the attributes. I found it to be a very, very quiet. The battery life is long lasting, which is wonderful. And even with the battery life being long lasting, if you forget to charge it, you can use this machine while it's on the charger, which is amazing. A complete 180 from the other machine that I got off of Amazon where you can't use it while it's charging. I know that seems like such a little detail, but if you've been using airbrush for a long time, it's something that is part of your daily routine or your day-to-day life. You'll understand why it's so important to be able to use a unit while it's charging. So I know people wanted to know a little bit about the PSI. I wasn't able to get an accurate read with my PSI meter. There's something that went awry with it and I didn't want to go ahead and put out a false number. So I just kind of did a little bit of compare and contrast testing with my other Dynair machines. And I came to the conclusion that as far as PSI, it's about equivalent to the PSI in that of the Crystal Series compressor, which is the Pro Variable Speed compressor. It's about 12 o'clock there. I will say that it is a little bit more powerful than my Dynair Go model. So hopefully if you have either one of those compressors, it'll give you an idea of what kind of power you're going to be working with. Do I feel like it's powerful enough to push out silicone-based airbrush makeup or even a silicone-based hybrid? I don't think so. I think it will. If the formula is thin enough, I think it'll push it out. But as far as getting that fine, mistified, smooth spray, I don't think that you're going to be able to achieve it with. At least I haven't been able to achieve that perfected spray with those formulas using the Dynair 1. So now that we covered PSI, let's go ahead and talk about charging time. So I did run this device ragged trying to test out the charging times. I don't recommend that you go ahead and do this yourself because it does put a lot of strain on the motor because you have to leave it running to test it out. At least I did that. So I don't recommend that you do it because, you know, you don't want to put strain on your device. Me, I do it for scientific purposes and testing purposes for you guys. So I was 100% willing to risk the motor on this baby to go ahead and test it out for you guys. So that being said, these are my findings. So I ran several tests at different periods of time, but the one that was the most controlled was the test that I ran initially at the go, at the start of it all. So I'm going to go ahead and share those results with you now. So the charging time for the light on the adapter, the wall adapter, there is a little charging light here. This is a light indicator. When you plug it into the wall and you plug your device onto it, the light will flash red. And then when it's fully charged, or in theory, when it's fully charged, the light will turn green. So that's the indicator that I went by on the first test. So from the charge time between that bracket of the light being red to green and finally turning green, I got a runtime of about 53 minutes of continuous use, which means continuous, like I never turned it off. It ran like this for 53 minutes. I did notice a noticeable decline in the pressure or the airflow at about 51 minutes. So I'd say on average, you can get about 50 minutes of use out of this device if you're running it continuously, having only charged it till the light turned green. Now, I did do another test to kind of see if I charged it for longer, would I get more time out of it? So I ran a test for charging it for about 4 hours. The run time for 4 hours of charging gave me about an hour and 3 minutes of continuous use, which is, it sounds like it's a lot more, but it's really only several minutes more for 4 hours or more charging. So I don't feel like charging it longer is going to give you that added bump. This is just a disclaimer. That's the results that I got with my unit. What I'm trying to say is results may vary, but these are the results that I got with my unit. So with the 4 hour charging time, I did notice a noticeable decline in air pressure at about 57 minutes. Noticeable decline means that the airflow started to slow down a little bit. It wasn't enough to go ahead and hinder me from being able to use the machine, but that noticeable decline did happen, so I want to make you aware of it. So that extra time between 57 minutes to that hour and 3 minutes, you're working at a lower PSI. So obviously that will affect the performance, which is why I say there's not too much water to be held there between the charging till the light turns green and then charging it for 4+ hours. But of course, you make that decision on your own if it's important to you or if it matters to you or not. I did go ahead and test the device using it for several days without charging it, charging on a full charge, okay? And I got about 6 days worth of full face airbrush makeup, including charting in between without having to charge it again, which is, it's mind-blowing. It's amazing. It's almost like, I think it's longer. I don't want to say it's longer, but it definitely rivals that of the Temp 2 Air. For sure. So honestly, the length and life of this device is very, very substantial. The battery holds a charge beautifully. And then of course, you can extend the life of that as well, which is why I feel like I got a longer amount of time out of this without charging it in between charges, because I was constantly turning it off when I wasn't actively spraying. I think that helped me a ton to extend the life. So if you do want to extend the life of any of your handheld devices, battery operated devices, I do recommend making sure to turn off the airflow when you are not actively spraying. That'll give you the most as far as timing with your handheld devices. When it comes to the overall charge, I think my final recommendation would be to charge it for about 2 or more hours. I think charging it between an hour and 40 minutes to 2 hours is probably going to be the best amount of use that you can possibly get out of your machine. Like I said, that was just running the test with my personal one here. So results may vary, of course, but just to put that information out there, if that was something that you were interested in, there you have it. So now that I feel you have enough information about the Diner One from me communicating it to you, as well as what you've seen on the screen during the duration of this video, I just want to go ahead and talk a little bit about my experience. So my experience with the Diner One has been very good. I have to say there's not much that I dislike about this unit at all. This is it. This is it for me. I've enjoyed it. I've loved it. I've had a good experience with it. The only thing that I will say kind of irks me a little bit about it, which is, it's like a personal thing rather than like a technical thing, is that when I'm spraying, because I'm so used to just holding the airbrush, I don't grip the body. And when I'm spraying, the body like tends to like drift and shift on me. So sometimes the on off button will end up like toward my palm and stuff like that. But that's just the nature of the Quick Connect adapter. And like I said, it's more of like a personal preference kind of thing rather than, you know, an actual flaw with the airbrush. So what I recommend if you're having that problem when you are holding the Diner One, or if you think that could be a potential problem in the future, is getting used to actually gripping the body of the One. You see, if you grip the body like this, I have a finger on the on and off button, turns on and off real easy. Pinky out. No, I'm just kidding. And yeah, and I can still go ahead and spray while holding the body of the airbrush. So if you're like me and you are used to just using the hose with the airbrush, that might take a little bit of adjusting, but it's definitely doable. So you can go ahead and get the most comfortable use out of the Diner One if you have it, or if you're interested in it, of course. All right, so outside of that little kind of pet peeve tidbit that obviously was easily adjustable, as you saw, there was not much con-worthy attributes on the Diner One that I found in my use of it. It turns out I actually really, really love it. It's taken the home spot here on my vanity. I take it with me from my vanity to my bathroom. If I'm ever going anywhere, this is the device that I pack with me, just because I found it to be very, very versatile. So, final question, do I recommend the Diner One? Absolutely. I feel like if you're looking for a handheld model, this is as good as it gets. So it checks off pretty much all of the boxes on what an avid airbrush user would want in a handheld portable device. So at the end of the day, I have to say that I do recommend it if you are looking for a handheld device to add to your lineup, or even if you are a beginner starting with airbrush makeup, because like I said, this is no fuss. I mean, it's fuss proof at this point because it has the one speed. You can detach and attach as many airbrushes as you need to go ahead and get your practice in, get your learning in. It also eliminates any cords and everything. So if you're transitioning from a regular makeup brush to an airbrush, I feel like your transition is going to be a lot easier because you're used to this part. So I feel like the Diner One is going to be something that's really good for people who are intermediate to advanced with airbrush, but also very, very good for those of you who are beginners at airbrush makeup. So this is a system that I definitely feel like I can say I recommend if you are a beginner. And then, of course, if you're intermediate or advanced, I do recommend to go ahead and pick this up just because of the convenience and versatility of it. So, that being said, that about wraps it out for this video. I hope you found this video helpful and informative. If you did, please give this video a big thumbs up. It helps me out a ton. And if you have the platform for it, please go ahead and share my video. This would help me out even more, and I would greatly appreciate it. And as always, remember to subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. And if you are subscribed, or if you choose to subscribe today, don't forget to hit that bell icon and turn on your notifications if you want to see more videos from me popping up on your feed. All right, loves, thank you so much again for watching, and I hope to see you all in my next one. Bye!